Hello friends, today you will watch how can we connect our camera to any PC, smartphone, tablet to watch live view. Normally we connect our camera to any computer or tablet or smartphone with wire. Wire tethering is a very cheapest way to connect our camera because we just need a wire, USB and tethering software like Adobe, Lightroom Classic, CaptureOne or DSLR controller and another third-party softwares. But it has a disadvantage because our camera is connected with the wire and sometimes it messes up. But when we connect our camera wirelessly, we just need to create only wireless network. You can connect any device, computer or smartphone with this wireless network and your files are transmitted every time you release the shutter button. Even you can control remotely your camera with your computer and smartphone, and you can assess every features of your camera.
When I bought Nikon D7500, I was not happy with its wireless connectivity, and it is a depend on Nikon software SnapBridge, and connectivity was also unstable. I was very disappointed as a loyal user of Nikon, so I will keep using wire tethering. A few days back, I just read that Nikon has already updated firmware version 1.10 last year for the D850, D5600 and D7500 DSLRs. That I overlooked the update. Normally, I never miss the updates. With this update, the primary improvements is something some photographers have been asking for years. Direct Wi-Fi connection to the cameras from the smartphones and tablets. Let's watch how can you use your Nikon camera with SnapBridge Nikon app and with the independent Wi-Fi or with any third-party software. First, check your firmware version. Open camera menu. Go to settings. Open firmware. I have already updated firmware 1.00 to 1.10 and it is the latest version. If you have 1.00 in your Nikon camera, you need to update it. Soon I will update a video how we can update firmware. Then go to Wi-Fi settings, go to settings menu, then go to Wi-Fi options. Here you find an option network settings. Open it, select SSID. You can see I named it D7500NI or find default name of your camera. You can also edit with the inbuilt keypad. Next option is authentication. As other network, you can select open or with password. I selected option WPA2. Third option is a setting password. I have already added here. You can edit yours. And fourth and last option is a channel. Here are two options, auto, other is a manual. You can select channel 1 to 5. After set the settings, you can establish network connection. So select the option establish network connection. As you select it, after few seconds, your camera is ready to connect your Wi-Fi network with SSID you have already created here and it is D7500NI. Now you can connect your camera direct to your laptop, smartphone or tablet. First you will watch how it will connect with the smartphone with the Nikon official smartphone software SnapBridge. You can download the software from the Google Play for Android and iTunes for the iPhone. I am using Android phone here. Now opening already installed SnapBridge, allowing the permissions, select the Wi-Fi mode, then connect the camera with the active Wi-Fi connection. Then you need to disconnect your internet Wi-Fi connection if it was connected. I am selecting here my camera Wi-Fi connection and it is asking for password. I am inserting the password to assess Wi-Fi network of a camera. You can see it was connected successfully. Touch the remote photography button. As you touch, you can see the scene in your smartphone and you can change your aperture here. Increase or decrease exposure values to bright or dark your image. You can also focus of your subject. As a focus box turned to green, it means your subject is in focus and you can take shot. As I touch the remote button, shutter released and shot was taken. You can also change the ISO speed here as well as white balance as you required. I am repeating the same action again to shoot next one. The image was saved in your camera, but you have also an option to save in mobile.
go to camera settings in SnapBridge, turn on the download button. You can also active the self timer. I am activating it by on the self timer settings. As I click on remote button, self timer activated for the 3 seconds that I set. After 3 seconds, the shot was taken by camera and image is downloading to smartphone. You can see the image with details here. This is an example image and I did not care about perfect settings. It is really useful in composing your shots. Now you will see how you can connect it with your PC. First, you need to activate your camera Wi-Fi connection as we connected with the smartphone. Open your PC network Wi-Fi access. Connect with the camera Wi-Fi connections with the same password that we have already entered in the camera. You can control your camera with many third-party programs. I have added the links where you can download these programs. I am using here qdslr dashboard for wireless tethering. I am opening qdslr dashboard and then clicking on Nikon button. You can see it is showing connected. You can see the all camera settings on the dashboard. Changing aperture 7.1 to 11, changing ISO 400 to 500. You can also change white balance from here. I keep it on auto. As I clicked on the live view button, you can see the scene in your PC. So you can compose your shot easily and also change any settings. Even you can also focus your subject. Now you can click on camera button on dashboard. Image will be saved on computer hard disk. You can also open your image directly to Lightroom that you just need to enable auto import in Lightroom Classic. Open file menu, then go to auto import settings. Choose the file location folder of a qdslr dashboard, then enable the auto import options. After that, connect your camera again. I am changing some settings. Intentionally, I am underexposing the image. As I click the camera button, image will be saved and open in Lightroom. Clicking another shot by setting correct EV value. It is a saving and opening in the Lightroom. So you can make necessary changes here. Here you can find many options in qdslr dashboard. You can use time interval option. Also you can use exposure bracketing. By clicking this button you can see all your camera features those you can use from here. So it is so flexible and control your all camera settings with the dashboard. You can download the same software in your smartphone and it is a paid software. Hope you will like this feature and love to use in the future. That's all for now. We will meet again with the new tutorial. Thanks for watching.